coastal areas of western Greece are affected by widespread coastal erosion, causing social and economic problems as loss of coastal land, destruction of coastal infrastructures, and impacting our tourism industry through partial or total loss of beaches. According to studies, the phenomenon of erosion is becoming more pronounced in specific areas of the municipalities of Patra, like Monodendri, Vrachneika and Tsoukaleika, and West Achaia, like Niforeika, Kalamaki and Alissos. Indeed, in some areas from 1965 until today, beach widths of up to 26 meters have been lost, while the river Piros has lost estuaries of 100 meters wide. The region of Western Greece is involved as a partner in the implementation of the Triton project, funded by the Interreg VA Greece-Italy program 2014-2020, and is installing one weather station and one tide graph in each of the two selected areas, Patras New Port and Kyllini Port. At the same time, it is planned for mid-October to be installed in the marine areas of Patras New Port, the first wave data buoy system in the region of Western Greece. Moreover, employees of the region and the municipality of Patra, as well as PhD students, participate in the summer school organized by the program leader, the Apulia region, to train them on coastal erosion issues, technically, financially and legally.
We are here in Kato Achaia Beach. It's one area part of the Triton project. Very interesting about this area because it's exactly in the middle of the Gulf of Patras. The decision to have this research area and to have as a pilot area with the Gulf of Patras because across the coastline, which is 50 to 55 kilometers long, we have detect serious problems of erosion, not erosion all along the coastline, but in different parts. So one part of our project is to investigate with geotechnical means what's happening here. Other part of the project is to investigate it with marine studies and another one with remote sensing and shallow water surveys. So what exactly we are doing here? We have all our equipment penetrating the ground and see what is happening with the properties of the soil. And the other thing is to detect areas where the sediment is being transported through high waves or currents and detect which areas need more protection. So, by concluding, the Gulf of Patras is very important for the city of Patras and the local authorities, the region of Western Greece, because it's the most dense populated area in the region. A lot of activities are performed, like touristic activities, building activities, and another commercial activities. And in the western part of the Gulf, there is a protected area, a very big fishery protected area. So it has all the necessary elements like environmental, anthropogenic and other elements we have very interesting to us. So by concluding and having in mind that climate conditions are getting worse over the forthcoming decades, we have to take an exact picture of the Gulf of Patras, monitor what's happening inside the Gulf and along the shoreline and decide which is the best protection measures to protect environment and anthropogenic constructions.
Generally speaking, the coastal environment is a very fragile and sensitive environment and is controlled by a number of factors. For instance, it's very important to know the sediment budget. I mean the supply of the sediments from the river. Another very important factor is the coastal processes. I mean the waves, the longshore currents, the tides, and the meteorological parameters, for instance, the winds. The climate change is another factor that may affect the coastal environment. And finally, we have the anthropogenic impacts. We have a lot of offshore construction and coastal construction that finally heavily affect the morphology of the coastline. In the Patras Gulf, and particularly at the southern border, at the southern coastline of Patraikos Gulf, We carried out a preliminary survey in the framework of Triton project, and we defined some areas that have been heavily affected by the erosion. And the causes, the main cause of the erosion in the area is mainly the anthropogenic factor, the anthropogenic impact. We have a very high degrees of the sediment supply from the rivers due to the illegal dredging of the material at the delta of the river, and we have a lot of dams that we have constructed upslope of the river. A very important and crucial point is that we have no scientific data regarding the coastal environment in order to design the protection of the coastal environment. That's why, in the framework of the European project Interreg Triton, we are going to carry out a very systematic survey using state-of-the-art geophysical equipment. We are going to collect very detailed bathymetric data. We are going to collect very detailed morphological data from the seafloor, and we even define the seismic stratigraphy, I mean the subsurface structure of the seabed. At the same time, we are planning to deploy a wave recorder at the area in order to have a very complete data set regarding the waves. And of course, we are going to deploy a meteorological station and the tide gauge in order to record the tides of the area. So all these integrated data set will be valuable for the protection of the southern coastline of the Gulf of Patras.
Professor Konstantinos Nikolakopoulos will demonstrate equipment we are using for the Triton project. Drones and this small boat over there. Drones is to take in aerial photographs, to map all the shoreline today, and to make comparisons with previous aerial photographs from past years. And the small boat over there is to have a scan of shallow water bed.
So we will perform a photogrammetric flight in the Gulf of Alikes. That means that we have designed a grid. The drone will go up at 100 meters and will take images at very specific points designed in previously with a photogrammetric grid. And after that, at the office, we will process the data and we will create orthophoto map of the broader area and also a very detailed digital surface model of the land and of the shallow water. We can have an accuracy of 2 or 3 centimeters with this procedure, both in land and in the shallow water. Okay. We also perform measurements with the differential GPS in order to georeference the data from the drone and from the unmanned surface vehicle.
For the purposes of the Triton project, we use highly sophisticated equipment. One equipment we are using is the cone penetrometer equipment test. Another in the future is the geotechnical boreholes, another equipment which is part of the Triton project.
And I will say a few words about the good remote sensing practice in for contrasting coastal erosion. What we do in the frame of Triton project. First of all, we use air photos, a digital satellite data, in order to monitor the coastline erosion from 1945 till today. A lot of remote sensing processing techniques are used in order to detect how the coastline a retreat for the last 73 years. Secondly, we use unmanned aerial vehicles, more known as drones, in order to perform photogrammetric flights along the beach in specific places in order to map with a very, very big accuracy the coastline. Also, we use an unmanned surface vehicle, a small vessel with a side scan sonar and also with a very accurate sonar in order to map the seabed. We try to map the shallow water environment, that means from the coastline up to a depth of 5 meters. And finally, we will create a geodatabase in order to integrate all the data, remote sensing data, marine geology data, and engineering geology data in a common geodatabase in the frame of Triton project.
The Interreg Greece-Italy program is a very important program, and we're very happy to work with the Puglia region on this scientific technical issue. We expect the results to be very useful for our societies and for our region and both of our countries.